Dana White.
Let's talk about politics and sports, shall we?
All right, we're going to create a new banner. This is a Jum Doc alert.
You see, conservatives rail against it.
When you go down and take a knee or any other way, you're sitting, essentially, for our great national anthem.
They preach the falsehoods of their side, demanding it be separated.
I will never agree with anybody disrespecting the flag.
He's allowed to have his view about what kneeling and the flag means to him. I mean, he's a person.
Yet here they are endorsing it.
It was clear his highest priority was always the health and safety of everyone in our country.
Here they are serving.
And congratulations to Dana White, UFC.
As an accomplice to it.
Kaepernick selfishly and single-handedly changed the whole dynamic of football, sports, and the unity those events used to provide.
Which is the direct opposite of their coordinated mission statement. They are the embodiment of hypocrisy.
I mean, this is beyond football, though.
Because they endorse political undertones in sport when it supports their narrative.
I'm Herschel Walker. Most of you know me as a football player. I've known Donald Trump for 37 years.
It's always unwise to seek political advice from someone who gets paid $100 million a year to bounce a ball, shut up and dribble.
And despise it, lambast it, and kick it to the curb when it goes against their agenda.
The people that have not voted for me specifically because of the things I've said or did, they've said it. They've come out and said, I can't vote for him because of what he said or what he did.
This is a deeply racist individual, a devout Trump supporter, and belligerent conspiracy theorist, Curt Schilling. You might know Curt from his bloody sock game with the Boston Red Sox. Bloody socks are also what the interviewer, Mark Levin, lists as his favorite meal at supper. Schilling is a bigot. He shared memes comparing Muslims to Nazis with the caption, "The math is staggering when you get to the numbers." Let's just go over why this guy absolutely sucks. Remember Steve Bannon? Remember when he was arrested on a yacht for defrauding people with his Build the Wall fundraiser? Curt Schilling served on the board. As a matter of fact, it was something he was so proud of, he tweeted links on how to donate via GoFundMe. Also on the board? Eric Prince, David Clark, you know, real winners. Marjorie Taylor Greene, a Republican congresswoman from Georgia, pushed baseless conspiracy theories, including one about Marjorie Stoneman Douglas. Schilling, an advocate for stupidity as a radio host with Breitbart, also supported this, retweeting a conspiracy theory that alleges one of the survivors from the mass shooting at the high school in Parkland was actually a paid crisis actor. Speaking of, not only does he support the baseless conspiracy theory that his president peddled into and basked in, but to no surprise, he supported the insurrection on January the 6th. Speaking of fake news, Schilling on his show gave a safe haven to a certified white supremacist, Paul Nealon. The outlet quietly deleted it from its archives. Not deleted? Schilling defending Donald Trump's lust for underage girls. Deadspin has the video via Fox Business if you'd like to see it. It's disgusting, but perfectly on brand for a shell of a man like Curt Schilling. When then Orioles outfielder Adam Jones said he heard someone use the N-word at Fenway Park, Schilling said it didn't happen and that Jones was manufacturing the story. Defrauding people along with a bevy of controversies is just like kind of Schilling's jam, including a failed video game venture called 38 Studios that defaulted on $75 million in loans from Rhode Island. He was later sued by the state. After ESPN suspended him, Schilling just couldn't help himself, posting a super offensive meme mocking the anti-LGBTQ law in North Carolina. What Schilling is doing is piling on the troubling rate of suicide, mocking trans people for just being who they are. Curt Schilling is also an avid collector of Nazi memorabilia. One Brown University historian said, "I've noticed that there is some kind of fetish with Nazi uniforms." Schilling also toyed with a run for Congress, showing how bigoted one can be in his mission statement. "The state is not the state I grew up in, making Arizona citizens of every race, religion, and sexual orientation second-class citizens to illegal immigrants is about as anti-American as it gets." He hates athletes expressing their political views, even if it's a silent, peaceful gesture like taking a knee, yet is surprised when he is judged for his own? Schilling, a profound idiot, compares voter ID laws to getting a coronavirus vaccine to prevent the spread of a deadly virus his president never tried to contain. He also thinks the media is the enemy of the people, posting this picture on his social media. Tough go when the media are the gatekeepers and voters to allow someone like yourself into Cooperstown.